talk about the gas valve a little bit. So as I mentioned, there are actually two valves inside here, two physical valves that are in series with each other inside here. And if you look at the picture here, so the gas is coming in over here, and this is the regulator. It's just mechanically actuated, nothing electrical going on with the regulator. And then it goes through, here's the coil. This is your split coil here. It's got three terminals on it. And so it's actually opening and closing a plunger for this first valve. So the gas's path, let me just draw that in there for you. The path of the gas is through the regulator, through this valve, through the first valve, through the second, the main valve or secondary valve, and then on out to the burner. And this second, this is your main coil or secondary coil, and it's operating that secondary valve. Okay, so I already explained about the gas valves, first valve, the split coil, second valve, the main coil. So let's move along here. Here's the cutaway, a cutaway view that we're going to look at here. So again, your gas comes in through here. This is the regulator. Now, your regulator is just mechanical, nothing electrical going on with it. Little bellows here responds to variations in pressure on the incoming supply, and it will move up and down. It will physically move up and down and change more or less gas that it allows into this port. The gas will then continue on once it comes in here. Okay, now it's got to get here, and you see they're calling out safety and booster coils here. This is your split coil. The next diagram will show us a little clearer, but there are actually two electrical coils in here. Both of these coils have to be energized in order to raise this plunger right here. So to raise that, both of them have to be energized, but only one of them needs to remain energized in order to hold the plunger up. If both of them lose power, then this is going to snap shut again. So everything's going well. We've got both coils energized. This one's open. Now it's going to come on through here. Now we get to our secondary or main valve right here. This is the one that right before it's going to go exit out the back into the page and go to the burner, out the metering orifice into the burner. This is a single coil here, so it just needs to be, once it's energized, it gets 120 or thereabouts, and then it's going to open, and then the gas will continue on its way out to the burner. Okay? So that's one picture. I'll show you another picture of how it works, but it's going to be a slightly different picture. Again, getting you used to seeing things functionally so you're not confused when you see things in a slightly different configuration. Same functional exact thing that we just looked at, but a couple things. The gas is coming in from a different direction. It's coming in over here now. Same type of regulator, and they're showing you a little better view here, the spring and the bellows. And moving this plunger up and down to let more or less gas in, comes up here. And what I like about this one is it's showing you the two coils. This is your split coil again. They're calling it holding coil and booster coil, which is fine. What did we call in the other one? Safety coil and booster coil, right? So your holding coil is another way to say is you'll sometimes see this called a safety coil. Different name for the same functional thing. So both of these have to be energized, and then it opens this plunger. Right now it's drawn in the closed position, but if this plunger opens, then the gas continues on here, and then same drill as before. The secondary valve, also called a main coil valve, for the main valve. So it can open once it gets voltage, and then the gas will continue on and then into the page and on out.